Hi, Katie Thulin, Dallas celebrity writer for Examiner.com. We are officially in the Christmas season, and Christmas Day is always a huge day for movie releases. The most anticipated movie of 2013 is The Secret Life of Walter Mitty, starring Ben Stiller and Kristen Wiig. Take a look. Local Dallas celebrity host, co-host of the Drew Pearson Show on Fox Sports, and also a producer with Solarity Studios. Paul got the chance to travel to New York City to sit down with Ben to talk about this new movie. Now, how was your experience interviewing Ben?
Oh, Ben's fantastic. He's always such a pro and just as nice as you'd imagine him to be, or you'd hope he would be. And, you know, one of the things I really liked about interviewing him is that we get to ask on the Drew Pearson Show the Hail Mary moments. And the Hail Mary moment kind of refers back to Drew famously caught the Hail Mary pass, and it's sort of become a pop culture term. So everyone has a great Hail Mary moment in their life where they just kind of had to go for it, and it worked out. And Ben's is extra special.
That's awesome. Now, how did this all come about?
Well, Fox was gracious enough to send me and put me up at the Mandarin Oriental Hotel, which is a beautiful hotel. If you've never been there, you need to go. And it overlooks Columbus Circle, and I was staying on the top floor, and I got stuck there because of the snow and ice here in Dallas, so I got to enjoy an extra couple of days there, which was absolutely fantastic.
Well, that's nice. Now, I know that you were lucky enough to attend a pre-screening of The Secret Life of Walter Mitty. Now, what is your opinion on the film?
I thought the film was very, very interesting. It's unlike anything you're going to see this holiday season. The thing about it is it's got elements of everything to it. There's drama, there's comedy, there's action, there's fantasy. And that's, in fact, the first thing I asked him right out of the gate is, what is this movie? And the more you think about it, the more you like it, because there's so many little things. In fact, I'd like to see it again just to get a second opinion on it. But I think people are really, really going to enjoy it and look back on it, and it's not as light and fluffy as maybe the commercial makes it look.
Interesting. Well, I know we all can't wait to see it. Now we're going to take a look at Paul's interview with Ben Stiller for the movie The Secret Life of Walter Mitty.
How are you?
How are you doing?
How's everything going today?
Pretty good.
Well, congratulations on this film.
Thank you.
Really, really fun to watch, and it's really hard to tell people what exactly it is. There's comedy, there's action, there's drama, there's fantasy. What is it to you?
To me, it's it is hard to sort of put it into one genre. It's a movie about a guy who's trying to connect with himself. It's kind of, I guess, he takes sort of a journey, but it's kind of an outward journey, but also an inward journey, and he's a daydreamer, so there's a lot of fantasies that he has, but it's really about trying to, I think, connect with his real self and be the best possible version of himself.
Yeah. And do you find yourself daydreaming a lot about, and if so, about what?
I don't daydream a lot. I will zone out. I will stop paying attention. If that counts as daydreaming, then I'm definitely, I do that a lot. I'll think about what I'm working on. Like, if I'm working on a movie, I'll spend a lot of time just thinking about it, and, you know, that ends up being sort of daydreaming, you know, because you're visualizing and sort of, you know, putting yourself in the world of what it is and trying to think of ideas or think of ways to solve problems, and I'll just retreat into that all the time.
Well, and you didn't have much time to do that probably on this, because you're the lead actor and the producer
right.
and the director, so it's,
well, yeah,
it's a lot.
That's true, but I mean, it is, but it's also the creative process is doing that, so really when we were prepping the movie, a lot of it was trying to come up with ideas and, you know, what's the best way to tell the story and what's the best fantasy here and how can we, you know, fix this problem in terms of, you know, that. And then acting, you know, is like the Walter was daydreaming a lot, so I actually did spend a lot of time thinking about other things being Walter, because a lot of times he isn't present.
Yeah, I think everyone has a Hail Mary moment in their life where they just kind of had to go for it, and it worked out for them.
Yeah.
What do you suppose that is for you?
Gosh, I mean, I think I had to try to get a job when I was first starting out, and I'd been auditioning, I wasn't getting any work, and I made a short film that was a takeoff on The Color of Money. The movie was The Color of Money with Tom Cruise and Martin Scorsese directed. And I made this little takeoff on it, and I brought it over to Saturday Night Live and asked somebody to bring it up on the elevator to the offices to show it to somebody up there, and ended up getting it on the show. So yeah, that was definitely a Hail Mary.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Yeah.
Hi, do you have any cars available?
Yeah, we have a blue one and a red one.
I'll take the red one.